along the road, it will lead you somewhere. So don't give up. Who is laughing at you? Your waiting time is not your wasting time. Tell them. Don't ever forget this. If you are not born again, you will suffer again. But if you are born again, get ready to reign again. Now in John 11 verse 39, the Bible says, Jesus said, take ye away the stone. Take away the stone. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, said unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he had been dead 4 days. Now I want you to understand that there is a stone that must be rolled. Now, I began to meditate on this scripture. Why will Jesus, the creator of all, the creator who came on earth and was like one of the created, why will Jesus, the author and finisher, begin to say, roll away the stone? Is it that he lacked power to roll the stone? Is it that he could not command angels to roll the stone? Why will he ask man and say, roll away the stone? Ladies and gentlemen, you may not understand it more until you look at the beginning of that scripture. In John 11 from verse 1, the Bible says, now a certain man was sick, named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and Martha. Verse 2 says, and it was that Mary which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Verse 3 says, therefore his sister sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, him whom thou lovest is sick. So you realize that the enemy came too late. The enemy came too late because it took someone who was so precious to God. He took someone who was so precious to God. And now, what do I know? Because they say him that thou lovest. That means Lazarus had made a kind of appointment, had made this covenant with the Lord in his service to God, that death cannot just snatch him. It's not possible. So while he was sick, they sent to Jesus. Now again, I've said it before, how come these girls were so bold to send that Jesus should come to their house? That means these same girls, if you read it, he said it was that Mary. It was that Mary. That means her giving prepared her way. It was that Mary who anointed Jesus. It was that Mary which anointed the Lord. That means her giving created access for her to be able to call God to come to their house. She didn't know the brother would be sick. She didn't know the brother was going to die. She didn't know there would be an attack in her family. But she was already connected. Some of you don't know, our coming to church is not just because of today. There's a day where you will value your Christianity. There's a day you are going to know that serving God is not in vain. I don't know if I'm talking to someone here. Him that loves is sick. Now, I ask myself, how come someone as rich as Jairus, a ruler of synagogue, could not stay at home to say, Jesus, come to my house? Like Jairus could not say, come to my house. Rather, he went out to meet Jesus. The Bible says he began to worship. That means he was rolling on the floor. How come Zacchaeus, a rich man, could not stay at home to say, Jesus, come to my house? He needed to climb the sycamore tree. He needed to go and look at a tree. I want you to imagine a rich man, you know, who will just be climbing guava tree just because Pastor Ben wants to pass. Am I communicating here? He said, why are you climbing? He said, I want to see him well. The man began to climb. Are you all with me here today? Do you know why? Because they never had this contact with him. They didn't have a way they served him. They didn't serve him with their resources. They didn't serve him with their lives. So there was no connectivity between them and Jesus. So the day they needed him, it was difficult for them to have access. But these guys stayed at home. Two small guys. They said, Master, come to our house. Him that thou lovest is sick. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus stayed briefly because whether he comes dead, when he's dead or alive, the author of life will always bring back life. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? How do I know? Because John 10:10 says, the thief cometh not to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Say, but I have come to give you what? Life, and life more abundantly. So you can see, the author knows what he is giving. If the thief come to steal, the author is the restorator. Now, let me go again a bit. Now, they said, him that loveth is sick. By the time Jesus will come, it took 4 days. Unfortunately, Lazarus was dead. And when he died, they began to look and they thought it was over. By the time Jesus we arrived, Martha met him and said, Master, if you had been around, my brother will not die. And Jesus looked at her and said, Martha, your brother will rise again. And there's somebody here, God say, I should tell you, you will rise again. Watch this now. Now Mary began to say, yes, Lord, I know. She didn't know anything, but she said she knew. And that's what the church does today. When we don't know, we say, yes, Lord, man of God, preach on, I hear you. You know, here. He said, I know. What do you know? I know. What do you know? I know. Then let me see whether you know. Let me show you that she didn't know. He said, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection day at the last day. At the last day. Mistake, you didn't know. Because if you know, the person standing with you is the beginning and is the last. So how can the author of beginning and last standing with you? You are bypassing beginning, you are saying last day, so you don't know. Turn to your neighbor now, say, what do you know? Are you sure you know? He said to him, I know. Jesus said, Kai, Martha. He said, I am. That last when you talk, I am the resurrection of life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall live again. Are you all so you can see she didn't know? She didn't know. Ladies and gentlemen, while this conversation was going on, they sent to Martha, quickly ran and met Mary. Unfortunately, Mary now is in the midst of professional mourners. Now, there are people in your life who will never show up until something bad happened. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying here? They never, if they hear you are blessed, they won't come. They will pretend they didn't hear. If they hear that you bought a brand new car, they won't come. Instead, when you are coming, they will dodge you. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? But let them hear contrary thing. Say one bad thing happened. Then you will not hit show them show. Neighbor, I hear what thing happened to you. Though, sorry. Hey, I know how you feel. Take her to, just take her easy. Not kill yourself. Though, sorry. And you. This year, nobody will tell you sorry. Whoever is planning to tell us sorry, we return sorry back to them. We return sorry back to them. You will shout it 3 times with me. You will say, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. You say, when I say one, nobody will tell me sorry. Two, nobody will tell me sorry. Three, nobody will tell me sorry. Are you ready now? That's one. Two. Three. All right, one. Nobody will tell me sorry. Two. Nobody will tell me sorry. Three. Nobody will. Sit. Are you still here? Ladies and gentlemen, they gather to be telling her sorry. We told you to take this church easy. We told you. When you say you have started to go to a new church, we tell you make you suffer. We told you to come join our village meeting. You for join our meeting. By now, we for help you bury your brother. Now, how you want to bury now? You know, any time they show up is to come and help you bury. But when Jesus show up is to come and help you resurrect. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? We told you by now, if you had joined our meeting, let me tell you the truth, you will not have paid for caskets. If you had joined our meeting, we would have bought a vehicle. If I would pay for ambulance. We will just help you ferry and go home free of charge. Why you not come join our meeting? Anyway, it is well. It is well. You see, now Jesus that you have been going to. How come your brother was sick? You sent for him, he not come. You know, there are people like that. When they come into your life, it's to discourage you. Please, this season, be careful of them. Because before your breakthrough, there will be attempt to break down. Before your original, counterfeit will come. Before your breakthrough, there will be discouragement. Something will come that will want to make you back out. Are you all hearing what I'm saying here? So you must be careful. And those you open your mouth to anytime you are discouraged. When you are discouraged, hide it within yourself. Pray. And look for those who are spiritually higher than you. Who can tell you? Are you all hearing what I'm saying? That the Lord will fix it. Ladies and gentlemen, this was the scenario. This was what they went through. They began to sit with her to tell her, well, that is all that life has for you. But ladies and gentlemen, Martha showed up from nowhere, and Martha said to him, and he said to her, he called thee. The master is around. Hey, please leave him. He said, are you going there again? But somehow, a quickening power, she went. And Jesus saw Mary. He repeated the same thing. Mary repeated the same statement. I know on the last day. Ladies and gentlemen, what Jesus now said is that, where did you lay him? Am I communicating here? Where what? Where did you lay him? You know, sometimes for you to get breakthrough, you must first know where your breakdown started. You must first know where your mistake is. You must first know where your error is. Because if you don't know where your error is, as you begin to rise, you will return back to that same error. And that's what you call rising and falling. Are you all hearing what I'm saying? Why will Jesus say, where did you lay him? Come, excuse me. Is he the author of life? Is anything hidden from God? Talk to me. Is anything hidden from him? Can you remember in John chapter 1 when he looked at Nathanael and said, I saw you when you sat under a fig tree. You agree with me? Jesus was here. He saw a man sitting under a fig tree in another village. Now, how come he's coming and he's still saying, where did you lay him? So God himself is the God of accountability. He wants to know that whether you are a foolish person. Are you all hearing what I'm saying here? He wants to know how intelligent you are. Sometimes God tests our intelligence. He tests. When he told Abraham, he said, look up and count the stars. And count the stars. Do you know some people would have given number? They would have come and said, well, I count 2,000. God would have said, you are a foolish man. So God sometimes tests our IQ. And one thing I just realized here is that within that space of time, where did you lay him? But sir, you are God. You knew where they laid him. But he wants to know whether you know. The same place where you join them, carry and go. Take me there. Are you all hearing what I'm saying here? Because sometimes you have to know when your mistake started. Don't use prayer to cover it. You have to know where you caught the gonorrhea. You have to know where you carry belle. You have to know. No father, you they carry pikin waka. And case not again, you want to carry another one. If you make one mistake, it's understood. But when you are going for another, those are the people that God is asking, where did you lay him? Where? And they said, come and see. And Jesus, God here, the Bible says he groaned. For the first time, Jesus groaned. For the first time, Jesus wept. He didn't weep because he lacked power. He wept because his friend has been packaged in a wrong accommodation. His friend has been packaged in a wrong package. His friend has been limited, removed from duplex into a small hole. And Jesus wept. He said, wow, you people could not just wait for me, but it's all right. By the time he will get here, that's my key point now. He said, roll away. Now, why will he now ask man to roll away the stone? Now, what I'm saying is this. What are the stones that must be rolled in our lives that God cannot help you? You have to roll it. Number one, the unforgiving stone. The stone that makes you not to forgive people. Your husband wronged you. Your wife wronged you. You took one diary, you wrote it down. You just wrote it down. You say, I have forgiven, but I cannot forget. You wrote it down. The next day she did something or he did something, you go back there, you write number two. You write and write and write. You become a scribe and Pharisee. You begin to scribe it down. So that is one stone, which we call stone of what? Unforgiveness. Number two is stone of unbelief. Stone of ignorance. In Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, he said, my people are destroyed for what? Lack of knowledge. Stone of ignorance. And the only thing that can cure ignorance is listening to the word of God. Allowing the Holy Spirit to do some mechanical work in your life. The stone of unbelief. Allowing the Holy Spirit to perfect all that he started with you. Are you still with me here today? If you heard me shout, I hear you. The stone. Ignorance. You may have missed education. Please don't miss salvation. You may have missed opportunity to be well educated. Please don't miss salvation. You may have missed opportunity for being a sociable person. Please don't miss salvation. Some of us came to church full of timidity. How do I know? Someone like Peter. Peter was an illiterate, a fisherman. He was full of fear and timidity. I can prove it. When Jesus was hung on the cross, a small girl looked at Peter and said, Peter, I know you are with that man. Peter stood before small girl and began to swear and said, please, I swear, I don't know that man. That's the same person that God used. Peter that was intimidated because of a small girl. Peter that was full of illiteracy. By the time the Holy Spirit came on him, Peter stood. After Acts chapter 2, Holy Spirit fell on him. He stood before multitude, no longer that small girl, after he has repented now. He stood before the well-educated people and all, they were all gathered. He looked at them. He started expounding the scripture from Genesis to Revelation, and he said, you, it is the same Jesus whom you crucified. Ladies and gentlemen, what am I saying? I'm letting you all know the type of stone that must be rolled away. Unforgiving stone. The next stone is what? Stone of unbelief. Stone of ignorance. Ignorance. Hosea 4:6. Cure your ignorance. Sometimes devil don't have hand in what you are going through. I can prove it again. In Ezekiel chapter 37, he put it, he said, the hand of the Lord was upon me, and the hand carried me and set me in the valley which was full of what? Please note it, the hand of the Lord. It didn't say the hand of Satan. The hand of what? So when the hand of the Lord carried him, he didn't take him to Buckingham Palace. The hand of the Lord did not take him to the great places of life. The hand of the Lord did not take him to White House. The hand of the Lord did not take him to Aso Rock. The hand of the Lord took him where? To the valley. Not just a valley, which was what? And he set him in the midst. So it will be an error to be in that valley and say, Satan, I bind you. In the midst. Don't bind God because you can't bind him. Then you are in that mist. I say, Satan, I bind you. Satan, I bind you. I reject this place. Shut up. Don't reject it. He sent you there for an assignment. There are bones around you that must live. There are bones. So you went there on a mission. And you are a man on a mission. Do I have men and women on mission here? Do you know you are a mission? You are a missionary to your family. Because some of us are set in that family full of dry bones. When you look at your uncle, nothing is happening. Look at your auntie, nothing is happening. Look at your father, nothing is happening. Look at the uncle, nothing is happening. But you are in their midst. And now God is saying, Son of man, can these bones
Can they buy their car? Can they build their house? Can they have a normal life? And that's why you are there. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? If you heard me there, why not shout, I hear you? Now, you can see that it's not Satan. So sometimes, the quickest way for you to die without solution, God forbid, is binding God in place of binding Satan. Say, well, I don't know. This problem is too much. You get there, you are complaining, you are going to be dry too. Because all those ones that became dry, they were all missionaries. They were all missionaries. They were all sent to the valley. But they were complaining, so they all got dried. They were sent there for an assignment. So when he got there, God spoke, Son of man, can these bones live? Some of us would have said, yes, Lord. Or no, Lord. He said, Lord, thou, because my life is hidden in you. I know I'm here for an assignment. Just teach me, Lord. Teach me. Ladies and gentlemen, God gave him the recipe. The simple recipe is prophesy. What did he say?
Prophesy.
Let the weak say,
I am strong.
Let the poor say,
I am weak.
Because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Don't you complain. Comply. Comply with God. Don't complain. You complain, you become like one of them. How do I know? Because by the time they grew up, he said, prophesy and blow. And the Bible said, they stood great and mighty army. Are we not armies of Christ? So all of them were armies, including Ezekiel was an army. Unfortunately, when they did cooperate with God, they became dry.
Oh my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, I pray for you. You will not dry in your situation.
Yeah.
I want to also look at another one. I look at Luke chapter 4 and Matthew chapter 4. The Bible said the Spirit of the Lord led Jesus into what? The wilderness, to be tempted of the devil. The hand of God led him. Matthew 4 and Luke 4, similar. He said, Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the devil. Who carried him there? The Spirit. Led him to be tempted of the devil. So God sent him there to go and write exams. God said, my son, I want to see whether you know what you say you know. Go into that wilderness. Go there. So he wrote the exam and he passed. How do I know? The Bible says he came out full of the Holy Ghost. He went there in the Holy Ghost. He did not backslide. He came out full of the Holy Ghost and immediately entered the synagogue. He entered the synagogue. In Luke 4, he entered the synagogue. When he entered, the Bible says they handed a scroll, because he has passed the exams there. They handed a scroll to him. And watch it now. And he opened to his own chapter. Not your chapter, my own. He opened to his own chapter. Everybody has a chapter inside. He opened to his own. When did he discover it? Inside the wilderness. He said it was delivered not only in the book of Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found a place where it was written. And now let us read now. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon us. Us. You. Who? You can see everything here is me. And he has anointed me to preach the gospel. He has sent me, not the word, me. Personified. I discovered my own. He had anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captive and recovering of sight, and to set at liberty them that are bruised. So he came to correct errors. And immediately all eyes were on him. But one thing he did, I liked. He closed the book. What did he do?
He closed the book.
He closed it and gave it again. He was simply saying, go and discover your own. I have discovered mine. You open your own. I will not open it for you. You open your own. Discover your name is also there. And from that day, all eyes were on him. When Jesus finished rewriting the story of Nazareth, sir, up till today, nations of the world, they go to Nazareth for pilgrimage.
they bring money to Nazareth. That's the same place where they say nothing good can come out of. I want to ask all of you, I'm talking about same you, same place, same family, same village, something good can break forth. Stand up on your
feet. Wow, I know you've been richly blessed by this message you have heard. Now, I want you to take quality decision this year to serve Him better. So now, this is what you do. In case you have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, I want you to say with me, say, Jesus, I come to you today. I am a sinner. Have mercy on me. From now onward, I choose to serve you all the days of my life. Thank you, Lord, for accepting me. And if you have said that prayer, I welcome you to the family, and I can now declare that you are born again, and I command all things to pass away. I bless you with favor. It is well with you when you go out. It is well when you come in. Arise and shine in Jesus' name. Amen.
You arrow, I said go and stop his activity. Now, go! Go!
I, Mr. Clinton, I decree today, any arrow sent against me, go back to sender now in the name of Jesus.
You arrow, why did you come back?
Do you want to be a terror to your troubles in life? Order your copy of Power for Daily Living, a daily devotional for champions by Reverend Ben Arabi, the Jesus Soldier, plus a comprehensive Bible reading plan for 1 year and daily mountain moving prayers at Divine Appointment Ministry International, 17 Oyewole Street off Shilon Street off Ikorodu Road, Pamgrove Bus Stop, Ilopeju, Lagos, Bible Wonderland, Suleri, or any leading Christian bookshop or vendors around you. Order your copy now and experience the power to triumph over the troubles of life daily. Distributors are also welcome.
Christ in me is the hope of my glory.
If you want Jesus in your life, let me see your right hand to heaven. Run! Run here!